said there is hope in your presence, in your presence. We bow to you, yes, Lord, we worship you, Lord. We worship you. We bow before your throne. We bow before your throne. We bow before your throne. We bow down and we lay our crown at the feet of Jesus. Greatness, love, and mercy and grace at the feet of Jesus. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy. We cry, holy, holy, holy. Is the love. See, we bow down. We bow down. And we lay our crowns at our feet of our Savior. Greatness, love, mercy, and grace at our feet of Jesus. See, we cry, holy. We
Jesus,
have your own way.
Have your own way.
Feed me.
Feed me.
Teach me your ways.
Teach me your ways.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Shall we take our seats? Quickly turn your Bible with me as we read Matthew, the chapter number 11. Matthew chapter 11. Today we are continuing our subject, how to become a committed Christian. Be committed. Be committed Christian. Be a committed Christian. To commit to something means to stay until the end. There is no wisdom in starting something which you cannot finish. It is not a wise thing to do to start with something which you cannot accomplish it. Therefore, it is required that every person that begins something must finish it. Every person that begins something must bring it to an end. Jesus shouted and said, "Come unto me, all ye that are labored and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, learn of me, For I am meek and lowly at heart, and ye shall find rest unto your soul. Learn of me, for I am meek, and you shall find rest. I am lonely, you shall find rest in your soul. Do you want rest in your soul? Come to Jesus Christ. Turn with me again to book of John, chapter number 6. St. John Gospel, chapter number 6. If we want to be committed to the Lord, last week we made mention of a few things. Before we can be committed to the Lord, we must have things in position. Number one, we spoke of living a life that are totally committed unto the Lord. We need to have a mindset of a relentless pursuit. One, we said that we need to have a gratitude heart. Number two, we need to have a heart of forgiveness. Number three, we need to be meditating upon the word of God. Number three, we said we need to set an active goal. Today we want to talk about having healthy food. Eating healthy. Jesus in John chapter number 6 went and preached, and as he was preaching, he said in verse 35, I am the bread of life. He that comes to me shall never hunger. I am the bread of life. Whosoever turns to me will always have something to eat. I am the bread of life for your soul. I am the bread of your soul. I am the bread of your spirit. I am the bread of your existence. Whosoever feeds on me shall never go hungry. He that believes on me shall never thirst. Two things that are very essential in our daily life: food and water. Very, very essential. Among the essential things, food and water. As for where to sleep, you can sleep whenever you are feeling sleepy. It does not necessarily matter where you want to sleep. You can sleep anywhere. You can sleep on a chair, you can sleep on bed. So where to sleep is not a problem at all. But what you eat and what you drink, what to wear is also necessary. But it shouldn't become our pursuit in life. So Jesus said, if we want to live long, we need to feed on him. We need to feed on Jesus Christ. Because he is the only bread. Read with me Matthew chapter 4 verse 4. He is the only bread for your spirit. God has not given any other food. In our everyday life, in our customs and our traditions, we have variety of dishes. Human body have variety of dishes. All the plants are food. All the seeds are food. Every vegetable is a food. Every fruit is a food. So we have variety. When we sit on the table, we have variety of types of foods to be eaten. But when we come to spiritual side, We have only one food. Please read for me Matthew chapter 4, verse 4.
Matthew chapter 4, verse 4. But he answered it and said, it is written, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of God.
Jesus said, quoted from Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 4, it is written, which humanity never understood. Jesus affirmed what has been written as a law for a man. If you want to be committed to God, you need nutritious spiritual food. Commitment to God is spiritual thing. It's not physical. And therefore, you are what you eat. You become what you eat. So if you don't eat, nourish spiritual food. Well, nourishable food. The tendency that you fall sick is very high. I don't know about you, but me, I'm very sensitive with my stomach. There are certain things I can't eat, yet I keep on eating them. And every time I eat them, they punish me. In some time past, I couldn't drink fresh milk. It's only when I came to Leicester, all these years, from the time I was born, so now, it's only Leicester that I've been able, that God has saved me from drinking fresh milk. Other than that, I will get running stomach. You must know, young boy Samuel is allergic to so many things. So the boy cannot eat so many things. His sisters and brother can eat whatever they want, but him, he must have a special diet. That is how spiritually we are. We have only one special diet. We can't eat everything as a child of God. The boy is sensitive. Even not every drink that he can drink. You must say that it's a burden for the parents. Yes, it is. It's a hard thing to do, to have a child that he cannot live abnormal life. He needs to have one life. The bread must be the same bread. He shouldn't change his bread. Man should not feed on junk. Today we think that we have a variety of food so we can eat everything. But I'm telling you, as a boy, Samuel is so it is, we can't eat everything. To become committed Christian, what we eat matter. When you go to hospital, there are three things: enough rest, medication, and food. Enough rest, medication, and food. Those people who are in they have body problems like stroke ward, they need to go through exercise. We come to that. They need to go through routine exercise. To exercise, what you and me can do for easy. A time is coming, you can't do it. What you and me can do without thinking, somebody needs to take his time to do. Life is not as we see it. It reaches the point that somebody wants to lift this arm, and the brain here to lift that arm is not there. So he has to use this arm because he thinks on one side, or she. So he has to bring this arm to carry this one. Understand this. Life as we see it is not as it is. There are stages in life. There are places when we reach, the grace of God becomes valuable to us. Many Christians don't value the grace of God. Many Christians don't respect the grace of God. And many Christians don't even understand what the grace of God is about. Beloved, let us be very, very careful. Let us be very, very careful, because the race is not for the swift, but the race is for the survival of the fittest. The grace is for the survival. The race is those who will be fit enough to carry on. And to be fit, you need good food. You need good, the word of God for your spirits. Some of the food that we eat, they are toxic. Some of the food that we eat, they are antibiotic. Some of them fight against some bacterias in our body. You know that some of the food are medication, they are medicine. Some of the food that we eat, they are medicine. And some of them, they destroy us. Let us be very careful what we eat. Jesus said, "For the bread of God is which come down from heaven and give life unto the world." John chapter number 6:33. "For the bread of God is which come down from heaven and give life unto the world." He has come to give us. He continued to say in verse 35, "I am the bread of life. I am the bread of life. He that comes to me will never hunger. And he that believes on me shall never thirst. But I said unto you that you also have seen me and believe not. You also have seen me and have taken this opportunity lightly." You also are hearing this, and sometimes we take this opportunity lightly. It is not enough to hear the word of God and not to take it into a crucial, effective life. It is not enough to preach the gospel to others while you yourself are not practicing what is said. It is not enough to be the hearer of the word of God. It is not enough to read your Bible. It is not enough to meditate upon the word of God. It is not enough to speak the word of God. And you are not being active. That the world is not changing you. We must be changed by the word of God, because we become what we eat. We must be. It is not automatic that when you read the word of God, it will change you. No. Physically, what you eat can change you. But spiritually, it is effective than the physical. However, your participation is needed. Why should a pastor who holds the word of God go to hell? In our ministry, we talk about heaven and hell. Our goal is that. In some churches, when you go there, that is not a team, because that is not a person of the people. And since it is not a person of the pastor, those people who come there without person, they lose it. Jesus said, "It is the Father's will that everyone that comes to me, I will keep him safe." In other words, it is the Father's will that everyone that feeds on me should survive. Everyone that practices the word of God must survive. Everyone. Do we want to survive? Then I want us to be very careful how we take this word. How we take this opportunity. Most of us are not working on Saturdays. So I don't see the reason why we must be here exactly what we call it? 3 o'clock? 1 o'clock? I don't see the reason why. At least we must be here 15 minutes if we are serious. At least. We need to come and arrange the chairs. We need to come and sweep the floor. At least. If we want to make heaven, let us be very serious. Let us be very serious. So long as we are not working on Saturday nights, I think we need to make it a point that let us 15 minutes the time we are here. It must be serious. Other than that, these things can cost our lives. Must cost us. The God that we are serving is well disciplined. The God that we are serving is a God that doesn't take chances. He who that much has been given much is required. He is giving us all these opportunities. And therefore, let us make good use of it. Other than that, we will miss the mark. We miss the mark. Some time passed, when it is time for me to go to church, and my wife has not finished, I will go. We must be very, very serious and committed with what we are doing. People eat this bread of life anyhow. This opportunity that the Lord has given to us, there are some of the sisters, exactly 5 minutes to, they are waiting. They've clicked, they want to be on Zoom and join us. And you are living here, you come 5 after, 3 minutes after, 2 minutes after, it is not a blessing. If we want to make heaven, let us correct our ways. Let us correct our ways, because punctuality, I'll talk about punctuality maybe in another, but many Christians couldn't make heaven because of their attitude towards Sunday service, towards the day that they meet God. Some of us have prioritized other things above God, and therefore we spend much of our time on these things, but we lose the most essential parts of our life. We need to take this opportunity. When we are talking about the grace of God is the helper that points us into the right direction of God. The grace of God is the one that directs us into the right path. So the grace is our ability to do everything, but the grace is the way points out. He is the one that directs us. When He directs us, it's your responsibility and my responsibility to follow His directions. He chastises us when we miss the way. He disciplines us and brings us back to the way. Many people have misunderstood the grace. We are in the grace period, so I can do whatever I want. I can go whatever I want. I can eat whatever I want. That is not. The grace show us the ways of God. The grace direct us into the will of God. The grace prompt us to know the plans of God that will lead a person into eternal life. Eternal life is not something to joke with. And therefore, let us be very, very careful. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16, please. 2 Timothy 3, 16. 2 Timothy chapter 3. If we want to make heaven, we need to live a committed life. And that committed life demands certain discipline. Certain habits must be broken. Certain habits must be destroyed. I want to do what I want. I want to do it my way. Must be destroyed. Being full of ourselves must be destroyed. Being full of ourselves must be destroyed. And we must be full of Him. If our life is not heading towards more of Him, we are wasting our time here. Effortless. Where's the life? 2 Timothy 3 verse 2, 16.
2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 16.
Aha.
I read this listening. All scriptures is God breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness.
All scriptures is given by inspiration. Inspiration means the Lord inspired it. God said it. God made it known unto man. And that is what the Holy Spirit said. Jesus said, when the Holy Spirit comes, He will make all things known unto man. Every lifestyle that you and me need to It must be known by the Holy Spirit. We don't know the way. Philip said in John chapter 14. Lord, where you are going, we don't know the way. How can we find the way? The Holy Spirit said, Jesus said, I am the way. I am the way, but don't worry. When the Holy Spirit comes, you find the way. You know the way, but you can't come there. But when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, He will help you to walk on that way. All scriptures are given for our nourishment. All scriptures are given for our corrections. All scriptures are given for our discipline. All scriptures are given for our profits, for our benefits. God did not give Bible for His benefits. Bible is not benefiting God. Bible rather restricting God. Understand that. So when you read Bible, God is there to do His will. God is there to do His promises. God is there to do His counsel. That is why a child of God, when you read this Bible, take it very seriously, because it has restricted God. God is bound by everything that He reveals to us. And that is why God doesn't reveal Himself anyhow. Because whenever He reveals Himself, He reveals to help and He reveals to destroy. He reveals to correct and He reveals to punish people. Hallelujah. Understand that. Understand that. All scriptures is given by the inspiration of God. It is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Reproof, correction, and instruction of righteous way. It instructs us to live a righteous life. The word of God instructs my spirit, my soul, and it puts discipline on my physical body. It instructs my spirit and my soul and to put discipline on my physical body, to submit. The physical body doesn't like instructions, which is the flesh. Look at these little children. Whenever you want to tell them to do something, they are as if they don't hear you. Man go astray, right from the onset. This little girl, when they was going away, and I was told, hey, come, she just ignored me and kept on walking. From infancy, we try to do what we want. We can't eat what we want. Whatever we are doing is what we are eating spiritually. When we say eating the word of God is acting upon the word of God. Acting upon the word of God. Putting the word of God into practice. Putting the word of God into practice. And how do we practice that? Do we practice them only when it benefits us? Do we practice them only when it is well with us? Or do we practice them when other people will gain advantage? Beloved, we need to practice the word of God in well manner that it will benefit us. Hallelujah. Apostle Paul said that having preached the gospel to others, I myself discipline myself. I put myself under the instructions of the Bible. We need to feed on the word. We need to allow the word of God to change us. 2 Peter chapter 1. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 19 to 23. The word of God is the best nourishment for your soul. The word of God is the best nourishment for our soul. Hallelujah. Are we there? 2 Peter
chapter 1.
Chapter 1, verse 19 to 23.
2 Peter
Yes.
And we have the word of the prophet made more certain.
Uh-huh.
You do well to pay attention to it.
Uh-huh.
As to a light shining in a dark place, until the day dawns and the morning star rises in your heart.
Uh-huh.
Above all, verse 20, you must understand that no prophecy or scripture came about by the prophet's own